Hi all my flashies, welcome to my new video, my new background, my new pictures, my new self with this scarf here. So, hi! Today I got 7 tips for young and new furries. So, I know a lot of you or some of you might be new or just even young, under 18, and don't really know how to behave inside the furry fandom. So I decided to give you 7 tips to help you out. The first point is, a fursuit is not a must-have for a furry convention. You really don't need a fursuit to be on a furry convention. When I talk to people, a lot of them are telling me, hey, I don't go to your ferns or another furry convention because I don't have a fursuit. And I want to tell you, not even 50% of the people attending a furry meetup or a furry convention own or bring their own fursuit. And what I think is really important, furry doesn't define itself by fursuits. Furry is the common interest in anthropomorphic animals, not the interest in wearing fursuits. This is the difference. And if you want to be a furry just because of fursuits, I think this is not the right idea of being a furry. Second point, art thieving is so horrible, but it happens way too often. Therefore, I got the advice, if you're a wolf or a dragon, use the Windbane Dragon Maker or the Windbane Wolf Maker. These makers are really helpful to create your own fursona. The links are in the description. And also, if you want to have furry art, for example cheap ones or free ones, I'm sure there are some forums where people offer cheap art of your fursona, that they draw your fursona and everything, because they want to improve themselves. So go search for it, I'm sure you'll find someone. Maybe also on Facebook and Twitter, just search for it. Don't cause drama. This is so important. Also because some people thought I caused drama by mentioning Odin Wolf and all of what happened. But what I dislike most is when people are saying, oh my god, I'm a new furry and I have no partner. I will be single forever. I am also single and I know how this feels. But if you're just crying to get attention or to be heard by other people, they will ignore you. If I see someone crying because he's single, I will never be or want to be in a relationship with this person. So just be yourself, get out, meet other people, but don't cry because you're single. Next point is, don't get too deep into the furry fandom. I know the furry fandom is a really interesting place with rainbows and everything. And of course, I love the furry fandom is awesome, but be sure to also have friends outside the furry fandom and to get out. If you're new in the furry fandom, you tend to RP a lot, spending a lot of time in front of your computer, maybe Second Life or other games or stuff that keeps you in front of your computer. And it's really important to get out, meet other people. This is so important. And if you don't have friends outside the furry fandom, I advise you to go to local furry meetups, go to conventions, meet other people. This is so incredibly important. Don't treat puppy furs like celebrities. I know in Germany, I'm also kind of a puppy fur and really, I don't like it. But if you look at Majira, Nosaina or other puppy furs, most of them don't like being treated as they were celebrities. Every week I got someone on Twitter, Telegram or elsewhere saying stuff like that. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, hi, are you Akiban? Yeah? I love you so much, I'm your biggest fan! And really, I don't want to be treated like that. I just want to make friends in the furry fandom, maybe all over the world. I love that. But please treat me normally. I'm not a celebrity, Majira is not a celebrity, Nosaina is not a celebrity. None of us are celebrities. We are all normal people, normal furries. This is so important because some people don't want to understand that we're no celebrities, we're just furries being on YouTube making, I don't know, cringy stuff and furry stuff, and well, this doesn't make us better than any other furry. Sixth point, take your time to create your fursona and your furry name. The worst thing that can happen is that you're a black generic wolf and call yourself, I don't know, YiffyPost92 or something like that. Actually, there are 2 points that are wrong here. The first one is, don't be a black generic wolf or a wolf in general. It's not bad to be a wolf, but a wolf is the species that is chosen from people who enter the furry fandom. I love wolves, and a lot of people do. So if they enter the furry fandom and don't know which species they want to be, a lot of them choose to be a wolf and change afterwards. For me, it would be really frustrating choosing a wolf, getting out of this fursona and changing it afterwards because I think, oh, a wolf is really not fitting my personality and my character, so I would rather more love to be a tiger, a hyena, an elephant, I don't know. So think about which persona, which species fits you. You need to identify with your persona, both how it looks like, for example the thing with Woodbane Wolfmaker and Woodbane Dragonmaker, but you really need to identify with the animal. It needs to be a part of you. And the second point here is, don't call yourself YiffyPaws92. If you're not sure about your name, I give you an advice, also how I got my name. Choose a word you love. For example, I don't know, a verb, an adjective, a noun, anything. A word that has a certain meaning to you. Then choose a language you love. For example, Spanish, French, Italian, maybe also German. Choose a language you love and a word you love. Then you translate the word with the language you love and see which word comes out. And then maybe you just change some letters, and at the end you have your own personal furry name. And you can be sure that there is no other person using exactly this name. I hope this will help you find a perfect and suitable name for you. And the last point is, meet other furries. I know I've said that before, but I want to mention it again because it's so important. Meet other furries, get out. What I don't like is when people just spend all their time in front of their computer and start to become socially awkward because they don't have experience in interacting with other people. So this is so important, meet other furries, not just because of getting out, but also just because of getting to know a bigger variety of the furry fandom, because you can experience so incredibly much. Have you ever been to a furry room party? Have you ever been to a furry panel on a big convention? This is something you need to experience yourself because it's so incredible. Well, so these were my 7 points. I hope I was able to help you, especially the new furries and the young furries. But also if you find some inspirations when you see my video, this would be so awesome. So if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. This would be so awesome. Press the bell, subscribe to my channel. That would be incredible. On the right, you can get to my face reveal video where you're able to see my face underneath this fursuit. And below, you can get to another video. So I hope you're having a nice rest of a day, week, or whenever you're watching this video. Stay possum fluffy. Bye bye.